Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillahillazi hadana lihaza wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. Innal hamdalillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiru wa na'uzu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina may yahdihillahu fala mudilla wa may yudlilhu fala hadiya la. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu amma ba'd. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has guided us into this, which is Islam. We would never have been guided if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not guided us. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help and assistance. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness, and we seek protection in Allah from the evil of our soul and from the evil of our actions. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, nobody can able to misguide them. And whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't want to guide, nobody can able to guide them. I bear witness there is no deity worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, with our partners and our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah's servant and messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the glorious Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا. وقالوا سبحان الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الحدي حدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O believers, O you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, get conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, and do not die other than Muslim. So we all have to die one day, today, tomorrow, any given time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set up the time of our death. نَحْنُ قَدَّرْنَا بَيْنَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ. So any given time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take us, we have to depart. We're not gonna able to come back. So whatever time we spend in this life, we have to use it right away. So our next generation is very important to us. So not only we go to heaven by ourselves, paradise by ourselves, Jannah by ourselves, we have to think about our next generation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, O mankind, I created you from one person, and from him I created his wife, and from both of them I created many men and many women. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and do not cut relationship among your own kinship, among your own family. Stick together, nasiha each other, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, O believers, O you who believe, get conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and speak the truth about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah one, no associates, and worship only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide us to the right direction, forgive our sins, and he will make us enter into the paradise. So our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the best Speech is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best guidance is guidance of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And people add things in Islam is matter. And these are bid'ah. And all bid'ah will take us to the Jahannam, a hellfire. So we have to watch what we do. We have to do Atiullah wa Atiur Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No other than that. So we have to be very concerned about ourselves and our next generation. You know, this is the month of Muharram. This is the first month, New Year's, today is the 13th. So this is the first month. We only count, only know when Ramadan comes. But this is the month of Muharram. The first month, the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what month of Allah is, Muharram. So Allah subhanahu, when he created the heaven and the earth, he created 12 months. Out of 12 months, the 4 months are sacred. Ash-shahru shuru, these are the sacred month. These are the sacred month, and the first month is Muharram. The Muharram, the 10th, whoever fasted, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive his 1 year sin before. So Muharram is very important. A lot of things happen in the Muharram. So we need to know the 12th month of Islam, the lunar month, Muharram, Safar, Rabiul Awwal, and all 12 months. And we need to teach our children too, same, or they will be lost. After we die, there will be nothing left, you know, because they will be like hopeless. So we have to think about what we do in here. So if we do 5 times a day prayer, go to the masjid and go and pray tahajjud and make Ramadan, you know, all 30 days and forget about thinking, you know, never think about our children, our daughters, our sons, what they are doing. Only us, we are thinking to go to the paradise. How about the amana Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us? Allah subhanahu gave us children. So we need to build their character, build their life according to Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we don't teach them, if we don't make friendship with them, they will find other friends, you know, other than Islam. We have to make friendship. When we pray, we have to ask them, we have to bring them inside. You know, if we pray in the masjid or house, you know, we have to bring them. Make jama, make a congregation prayer, and love them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us children, and we forget about giving them da'wah of Islam. We forget about teaching them Islam. We just go to masjid, we go to halakha and everywhere, and forget about our children. So we'll be lost here and hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doesn't matter how much ibadah we do, it will be spoiled. We have to go to the Jahannam if we don't take care of the amana. So what we need to do, one person, one man came to Ali radiallahu anhu, you know. So one man came to Ali radiallahu anhu and he said, Amirul Mu'min, my son don't listen to me, you know, he is disobeying me. Our beloved Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, did you teach him Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The man said, I was busy with making money and I was busy with giving him, you know, wealth after I died, and I didn't, because he neglected. So Ali radiallahu anhu say, that one is more important. You know, that one, the financial stability for your son is not important. The important is knowledge. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, talab al-ilm faridatun ala kulli muslimin wa muslima. So everyone, we supposed to get knowledge of Islam. We supposed to know Allah, so who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, why we are here, where we was before and where we are heading. We're not going to be able to come back to this earth and see the sun and moon and daughter and wife and son and father, anybody again. You know, when we depart, everything is gone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this life as a test film. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the mouth and life and death, to see who can do better than others. That's the purpose of life. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. So we have to make ibadah. Other than that, nothing else Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. So our children is amana for us. We need to teach them. We need to teach them, introduce about Islam. We need to learn first. You know, we need to sit down with them at least a few minutes a day. Sit down and with them. Take the cell phone away and just let them sit down. Because these days, the cell phone, you know, wife on the corner of the room, husband on the corner, and the son and daughters on other corner. And they are not talking to each other, they're talking to social media. So the Facebook and Twitter and everything, they are engaged. But we have to make borderline. We have to, first priority is the who is the creator, what the purpose. You know, the phone is important, but it's not important like 24 hours, just keep yourself in the phone. So it's important for us to sit down and talk without phone, without anything. We talk about the creator, we talk about the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just read one hadith. Ask the children to read the hadith and learn from there and what the benefit. Start with the salam. The salam, the greetings. You know, we can ask what it was salam. But before even salam, we need to know what salam is. The older us, you know, seniors, we don't know what salam is. You know, even we never give salam when we enter in our own house. We never give salam in the masjid. We never give salam in other houses. So salam is most important thing in Islam. The salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِذَا دَخَلْتُمُ الْبُيُوتَ فَسَلَّمُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ تَحِيَّةٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ مُبَارَكَةً طَيِّبًا. How you can get peace without giving salam to your house? How are you going to get peace without giving salam to others? The first word of Adam alayhi salam was salam. He introduced with the angels, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, give salam, assalamu alaikum. Then the angel say, wa alaikum salam or rahmatullah. So this is the greetings till the yawmul qiyamah. So when we sit down with our children, you know, only for a few minutes a day, we just talk about, start with salam. And first we need to learn and make habit our salam, because this is fard. When we enter any house, we have to say assalamu alaikum. So any house, even our house, we say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. So whoever in the house, if house is empty, still we need to give salam. What salam will do? Take all the devil out from your house. What salam will do? Bring peace in your house. If we don't give salam, then we have violated the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In our culture, we never learn these things. Salam is fard. Salam is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, فَإِذَا دَخَلْتُمُ الْبُيُوتَ. So when we enter into the house, we have to give salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَسَلَّمُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ تَحِيَّةٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ مُبَارَكَةً طَيِّبًا. It's mubarak, is rahmah, and everything will bring to your house if we give salam to your own house. We go out and we see, we wait for somebody else to give salam, but we never give salam. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even when he sees young kids, you know, he gives salam first. Because if we give salam, then they will learn, they will give a salam back. You know, so we need to teach them about salam. So let's start with salam, sit down with our kids, let's promise, so those next generation, they will make their base stronger, you know, if we teach them about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So may Allah give us tawfiq, may Allah forgive our sins, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only us, we need to go all together, our family, everybody together to the paradise. So in order to do this, we need to teach knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, knowledge and action. You know, together Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive our sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful and most kind. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرْ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Alhamdulillah, hamdan kathiran kama amar. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la irghaman liman jahada bihi wa kafar. Wa ashhadu anna sayyidina wa maulana muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu sayyidul khalaiqi wal bashar. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Inna allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina maulana muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi masabihil ghurar. Ibadallah, ittaqillaha ta'ala fi sama'i al-laghwi wa fudulil khabari wantahu amma nahakum anhu wa zajar. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina maulana muhammadin نور القلب وقرة العين وعلى آل محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذريتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأهم وأتم وأكبر. أقيم الصلاة.